Have you ever wondered what subatomic particles are made of? Quarks and gluons are the building blocks of protons and neutrons, which in turn are the building blocks of atomic nuclei. Our current understanding is that quarks and gluons are indivisible. They cannot be broken down into smaller components. They are the only fundamental particles to have something called color charge. In addition to having a positive or negative electric charge, like protons and neutrons, quarks and gluons can have three additional states of charge: positive and negative redness, greenness, and blueness. These so-called color charges are just names. They have nothing to do with visible color. The force that connects positive and negative color charges is called the strong nuclear force. This strong nuclear force is the most powerful force of all the four fundamental forces. It is much stronger than the three other fundamental forces, gravity, electromagnetism, and the weak nuclear force. In fact, it is so strong that it creates atomic nuclei. Because the strong nuclear force is so powerful, it makes it extremely difficult to separate quarks and gluons. The only way to separate these particles is to create a state of matter known as quark-gluon plasma. In this plasma, the density and temperature are so high that protons and neutrons figuratively melt into a soup of quarks and gluons. This soup of quarks and gluons permeated the entire universe until a few fractions of a second after the Big Bang, when the universe cooled enough so that quarks and gluons could form into protons and neutrons. As of publishing this video, quarks and gluons are considered to be the smallest fundamental particles. Therefore, they are indivisible. There can be nothing smaller. Do you think we'll ever discover anything smaller than quarks and gluons? Post your point of view in the comments to contribute to the discussion. Be sure to like and subscribe for more mind-bending scientific content.